1370 WOCA. Ocala.
We've got about 16 minutes to play.
Oh boy!
More than that.
Oh boy!
Because we go over the top of the hour.
Am I live?
Good morning, Joe.
Good morning.
You are live. You are live, not Memorex.
That's true.
Not Memorex. That's an old. That's started. Those kids that were in here earlier didn't know who Frank Sinatra was.
I heard. I heard. They need to be edumacated. come on, old Blue Eyes.
So live, not Memorex, is also probably passé. It's gone.
That's gone. That's with the guy in the big chair with the hair going back. with the headphones on. Right. I remember that.
So you ready to play a game?
Sure. What have we got to give away today?
Joe gave us way more things than we thought we had, Robin.
Wow, nice.
We are going to give away to one person the following list of gifts. Are you ready?
Yes, sure. Start off with...
We have two tickets to the Ocala Civic Theater to see... What's it called again?
Six Women with Brain Death.
Yeah.
Or and Aspiring Mind.
That's $44
right there. That's $44 right there. There's another $10 gift certificate to Tommy's Smoke a BBQ Joint... Whatever.
Yeah,
it's a restaurant.
Food. That's food. A lot of food.
$10 there.
Uh-huh.
So now we're up to
54.
There are two. Is this two or one, Joe?
I don't know.
This one.
I don't know. I really don't know.
All right, let's see.
They open it
Captain
up.
John Sims is the Singing River Tour captain, and this is good for one. So you got one.
Okay.
You pay for your friend. This is worth...
22, I think it is.
I don't know. $15.
Okay, that's 15.
You got a cheap date
there. We're up to 69.
So take a boat. Yeah, this guy is very, very good, and he's in Denali, and he'll take you on a pontoon boat ride and sing to you and teach you about the environment. It's just fun. Just pure fun.
He's a songwriter, member of the Florida Friends. He's great.
Plus, there's a free oil change from Double D's Automotive.
So that's at least $25.
All right, what are we up to?
I'm working on it. I'm worth 94.
All right, and now add another 25. Because you've given me a $25 gift certificate to Top Gear Bicycles, and you can use it for anything in the store.
So we're up to $119
there
to the winner.
Wow.
That goes to the person who bets on the winner.
What a prize.
Between Robin and Joe, today...
Am I doing my job okay?
You're doing very good.
All right.
Today, the category is songs that have been in... that have won the Golden Globe for Best Song of the Year.
Golden Globe.
The Golden Globe, which is kind of like the Oscars... They both do movies. Yeah, Dan knows a bit more about this than Robin.
The Golden Globe.
I don't know much.
Another awards ceremony.
It's another movie awards. But I have the five nominees for this. Is it next week, 2 weeks? The Golden Globes is coming up.
Yeah, you're asking me.
Up in a couple weeks.
I'm in radio. I don't know about the Globes.
All right. So I've got the five nominees for this year, plus the winners from the previous years.
We should have a WOCA award for something.
Yeah, we should.
We do. We won. Okay, next.
All right, so if you want to bet, you want to play, we can only take two players. We need somebody to bet on Robin, somebody to bet on Joe.
How do they do that? Well, they call the WOCA Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622. Larry, you look tired this morning, so I do
it for you. Do I really?
No.
When I get older, I'm going to be retired.
Oh.
I'm not for a long time. I don't plan on
retiring. Now, that's what happens when you work. And then you get tired, then you go back to work, you retire again.
All right, we'll take a little break and be right back. You need to call off the air, and once we get two players, we'll be back.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
Life's journey has many ups and downs, but you can take comfort in the knowledge that Robert's Funeral Home is here to serve you and your family with loving care and dignity. The Roberts family has been providing their caring services since 1898 and offer traditional, custom, cremation, and veteran services. Pre-made arrangements are also available. Roberts Funeral Homes, great funeral homes serve great people.
What's up, Ocala?
This is Joel.
And Amanda.
With What's Up Ocala Magazine and Media.
We want to invite you to come see Ocala's top fashion designers.
And models.
The New Year's Kickoff Business Expo begins at 1:30 with a never-to-forget fashion show following at 6 p.m. What's Up Ocala will have food, live music, and vendors showcasing their new products for 2013.
Categories of fashion include dress to impress, equine, business casual, a weekend away, local designer showcases from Game Day Dresses, and the Tutu Factory. We will be ending the show with a complete bridal transformation. This is the largest fashion show Ocala has ever seen, emceed by the one and only Kelly Hart, with performances by local and national bands.
Sponsorships and vendor booths are still available. Be sure to attend this free event and stay connected to our updates by visiting our Facebook page or downloading the What's Up app from the App Store and Android Market. It's free.
The 2013 Ocala's Choice Awards will be presented at the show. This is an event you don't want to miss.
What's up, Ocala?
Wee! Boy, we have fun off the air, don't we?
We have the business of talking. All right, we have our two players. Ann is betting on Joe.
All right.
Jeff is betting on Robin. Now, these are all Golden Globe song winners except for the first five.
What?
One of the first five
will be a winner.
Will be a winner, yes, when the Golden Globes comes around the corner.
Oh, so you're being sneaky. So you're getting nominees.
Yes, these are the nominees for the upcoming Golden Globe Awards.
Okay.
All right. Are you ready?
You got that, Robin?
Yes, I do.
And by the way, the Golden Globes is celebrating their 70th year this year.
The Golden Globes.
Yeah. So they've been around a long time.
You know what I'm thinking?
No.
The Oscar is a statue of a man.
Right.
Nude.
Is he?
I think so, yeah.
He's almost anatomically correct.
Yeah.
He's nude.
Almost.
Yeah. Neutered or nude, whatever you want to say.
Nude. Yeah, I think he's neutered.
All right. What is the Golden Globe Award?
Good job. Good job getting my mind to go where it needs to go. All right, here we go.
Shall we continue?
Here we go. Now, this is from a current movie. All right, what movie is it from? Who's singing it? And what's the song called?
A different place. Somehow full of grace, full of light.
Les Mis?
Yeah,
Les Miserables.
Oh, my.
Yeah. Who's the singer?
Wolfman.
Not the Wolfman, no.
Not the Wolfman singing? Okay. You know what I'm talking about. The guy that played the Wolfman on X-Men.
I don't know.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, Hugh Jackman.
Hugh Jackman is right.
You got it, Robin. I got to keep my mouth shut and talk to myself.
Any idea what the song is called? The way you do.
I'm so afraid.
Just a child who cannot know that danger follows where I go. There are shadows everywhere and memories.
Shadows everywhere.
I cannot share.
Wow.
I'm just
listening to him. I
didn't know Hugh Jackman could sing.
Well, I'll tell you a little bit about this in a second. Like this.
Oh, you know about it? Have you seen the movie?
No. Well, I've seen the play.
Okay. The gift of life. But you don't know the song, huh?
Oh, The Gift of Life.
No. The song is called Suddenly.
Suddenly.
Oh.
So tell me what you know.
When they actually shot the movie,
uh-huh.
They actually sang. They didn't mouth to a,
oh, really?
To a soundtrack. They actually filmed them singing song.
Wow, so, that's amazing.
So yeah, that was a little
I might like that one. I like that
kind of
thing.
That was a little different.
All right.
Okay.
Admitting that you like that kind of thing is like saying you're gay, but I'm not gay. I do like that kind of thing.
No.
What kind of thing?
It's that movie.
I see
and
the
Joe's
play.
Not gay. He likes it.
Who does?
Me.
Joe's not gay.
I'm here. Oy, ay, ay, ay.
All right, here's another one.
Oh, lady!
All right, here's another one. What movie is this from? It's nominated for a Golden Globe Award this year.
I'll guess the year. My heart
burns. Carly Simon?
No.
This is the end.
No.
I've drowned and dreamt this morning. Skyfall.
Skyfall is right, yes.
Oh, wow. Oh, James Bond.
Well, that's the name of the James Bond Skyfall thing.
That's the name of the movie. What's the name of the song?
Skyfall?
Skyfall is right.
All right, 2 points.
And who's the singer?
Oh, that's the A word. Adele.
Adele.
Whoa.
Yeah, now it sounds James Bondish.
Yeah.
Well, I thought the beginning of it was the name. the year 2012. We're not getting that.
Did he get that point?
No, I guess not.
No, of course not. These are all 2012. Until I tell you we're done with the 2000. That was the second of the five nominees. Here's the third one. What's it called and what movie is it from? Who's singing it?
Close your eyes. The sun is going down.
Cyndi Lauper?
No, it's not Cyndi Lauper. All right, looks like you're getting some help from some listeners.
Please.
Yeah, call in Ann, call in Jeff.
Come on, do you know anything about this one?
No. just some information on Hugh Jackman. He sang the role of Curly in a PBS production of Oklahoma. About 3 or 4 years ago.
Yes,
he can sing.
There you go.
Wow.
Curly. Thank you, Jim.
Different kind of curly.
Is this Jewel?
This is not Jewel, no. I thought you almost had her.
Call in, Jeff. Call in, Ann.
The Judge?
No, not the Jugs. This is Taylor Swift is singing it. It's from the movie The Hunger Games.
Oh. Really? I've seen that movie.
And the song is called Safe and Sound.
Okay.
All right.
I didn't see any of that.
It's up for a Golden Globe Award.
Three strikes, we're out.
Here's the fourth one on the list of current songs up for a Golden Globe Award for best, I think they're called Best Original Song of the Year. Here we go.
Live with memory.
What?
You slip this sea note up your sleeve.
The one with Will Smith, the Django or G something or another.
No, not that one.
Okay, never mind.
That's a good guess. Sounds like a cowboy song.
It does.
Always running.
Huh?
Always running. I can't understand the word.
You're close.
Always loving.
No.
I like my version better.
Yeah, me too.
All right, no one else, huh?
No.
That's from a movie called Stand Up Guys.
Sorry, okay. Never seen that one.
And that's John Bon Jovi singing.
Really?
Oh, wow.
And the song is called Not Running Anymore.
Oh.
Kind of what happened to my toilet.
Oh, you fixed it.
I fixed it. Well, that was the old one. The old one wasn't running.
So that's not nominated anymore.
Is the new one okay? Or is that
the new one's okay.
Now?
No, the new one's okay. The new one's
Thank
okay.
you for that information. All right, then.
But when you listen to John Bon Jovi right there, you think, boy, he's trying to sound like Springsteen.
Yeah.
A little bit. All right. Here's another one. Here's the fifth one of the five. So one of these will be selected as the Golden Globe Original Song of the Year, whatever they call it, from the movies. Name the movie, name the song, name the singer. Here we go. Wait, same one. Hold on.
John Bon Jovi.
Hey. Well, we're waiting here, yeah.
Yes, here we go.
Smoking fire, I didn't feel a thing. But suddenly I was rising higher, and I felt like
Alan Jackson?
No, you're in the right ballpark.
When I thought about my unborn child, when I thought about my wife, and the answer rang out clear from somewhere up above. No greater gift has
been. No greater gift?
His life for love.
No.
For love?
No. You're close.
Would I give my life?
Would I give my life?
No, good morning.
Would I give my life for love?
There you go.
No, good morning. Do you know?
Is this Keith Urban?
That is Keith Urban. Yes, you got a point.
All right, I'll give it to Robin.
Do you know what movie that's from?
Thank you.
No movie. Okay, that's Keith Urban. Robin gets a point, and it's from the movie Act of Valor. Act of Valor.
Oh,
well, it must be a war.
What's the name of the song?
The song is called For You.
Oh.
So you were very close.
Oh, close. Well.
All right.
Okay, but so no cigar.
We're not playing horseshoes.
So those are the five songs that are up for grabs at the next Golden Globe.
Uh-huh.
All right, now let's go back in time a little bit to another year. Here's the one that won. I'll tell you the year. This one won in 19...
Oh, we don't get to the year. That's not one of our points we can guess?
All right. I thought it would help if I told you what year.
All right, let's go for it then. Why not? What year?
Tell you the year?
Sure.
1967.
Garfunkel.
But if I'd ever leave you.
Robert Goulet.
Close.
How could it be in autumn? How I'd leave in autumn.
Oh, this is the King movie, the one with Richard.
Camelot.
That's it.
Camelot is right, yes.
There you go.
Finally, she opened her mouth and I got something.
Hey! Right. Who's singing?
Richard Harris.
No.
It's not Robert Goulet.
No.
Not Richard Harris, Robert Goulet.
Well, who else were the other two? There's... Oh, my gosh.
And could I leave you running merrily?
If ever I leave you.
If ever I would leave you is the title, okay. Yes.
Or on a wintry evening when you...
Richard? Is it Richard?
It's Richard something, yes.
Oh, Richard Burton.
Richard Burton is...
That's
right.
The one. Yeah.
Okay.
Now, but my big mouth.
I didn't realize. There we go.
All right, let's come a little bit closer to
the... That's right. Richard Burton, Elizabeth Taylor. That's right. Yes, yes.
All right, here's one from 1988.
Okay.
Let me see if I get the
88.
Right.
88?
This is from 88. This one.
Okay.
Right, all right, here we go. What movie, what song, what singer?
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's Carly Simon.
Yeah.
Wow.
And that's, the movie with the fairy.
With the fairy?
let the river run.
Right, right.
I'm getting slaughtered with this one. She knows everything.
Oh, it's not working, girl. It's working,
it
girl.
It is working, girl.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not working, girl. Yes, it's working, girl.
I love this movie. Great song.
It's an inspirational.
It's a wonderful song.
There you go.
It's inspirational.
She's on a ferry.
She's on a ferry.
Yeah, driving across there into New York when you see the video.
Driving across on a ferry.
Yep.
All right, here's one from 2011.
Okay.
That's why they call them Golden Globes.
Here we go. This one from 2011. This is, I guess, last year's winner.
Oh, wait, Larry.
Yeah.
This is WOCA Ocala.
That's right. That's
the
right.
Source.
That's right. It is. Here we go. What song, what artist, what movie?
Madonna?
It is Madonna.
Wow. What year?
2011.
I'm on your side.
No.
A masterpiece?
Masterpiece is the song, yes.
Wow.
The movie?
Indestructible.
No, is it He-Man? I'm trying to think of a cartoon. He-Man?
It's not a cartoon.
Oh.
Unbreakable.
No.
That was a movie.
I know.
But we said no. He laughed at my answers. He laughed at my answer. Somebody call in. Rectify me.
What movie could this possibly be from?
Kimani, do you know what movie that's from?
Is it from the artist?
No, not the artist. No, that's a good guess. No.
Mary, can I make a quick comment?
Go ahead.
If the Golden Globes are 70, they're probably not round anymore.
We'll just have an uplifting experience.
All right,
on this
that
area.
Is from a movie called W.E.
Okay, haven't heard of that.
And I think W.E. stood for...
What?
Wallace Edward.
I don't know.
It was a true story of... I looked it up this morning. Because I didn't know if my notes were right here. It was a true story of a man destined to become king, but he falls in love with a lady who's already married, and there you go. I think it's a British story.
That's from yesterday.
It's a boy and a girl story again.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Wearing a hat.
Exactly.
Here's another one. What movie, what artist, what song?
Clouds are so low, you can...
Oh,
and so
Gene
is right.
Come out to the meadow, Gene.
Is it John Denver?
It's not John Denver.
No, it's the other guy. Gene, oh, what is his name?
You're young and alive.
1971?
69 is the date.
69, I was close. Right? Okay.
Oh my God! It's not Billy Joe Royal.
No. Come on, do you know this one?
Well, that's the popular recording by the artist Oliver.
Oliver's right. Oliver. Yes.
Who gets the point?
Yeah.
What movie was that from? Do you remember?
That was from the Prime of Miss Jean Brodie.
Two points. Yeah, who do I give them to?
Joe.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yeah, that was Oliver. I'll tell you, I'm not really 100% sure if that was from the soundtrack or not. So
what happened to him?
It might not. I don't know.
Oliver.
He made his millions and is living in Ocala somewhere.
I think he moved to Green Acres, didn't he?
Who knows?
So. With Zsa Gabor. Or Eva. Eva, I think.
Right, here's another one.
Oh, that's Eddie Albert.
What movie, what song, and what artist?
I don't know. Denying
it. You're all tangled up in my hair. Hair?
Who?
Hair, she said.
No. Old
soldiers just fade away. Did you tell us the year, or are we guessing the year?
2004.
Oh.
Definitely not Hair.
Not Easy Riders.
Oh, Happy Sky. I don't
know. Oh, that sounds good.
No.
Is it a war movie?
I don't know.
I don't know what it is. I can't catch it.
Oh, look at the dog.
Oh, that's a nice dog. Security dog, yeah. Special dog.
All right, nobody knows this.
No,
one,
we don't know what it is.
All right, that's Mick Jagger and Dave Stewart.
Oh, my goodness.
It's, really?
From a movie called Alfie, and the song is called Old Habits Die Hard. It won the Golden Globe in 2004.
Alfie. That's not the song I connect with Alfie.
I know.
Because it was a remake, right? And the other Alfie was song in the was 60s. Different.
I
yeah.
know.
Yeah, the Alfies were in the 60s, 67.
All right, so here's one from 1981.
Oh, Christopher Cross.
Yeah.
New York City, yeah. No? Yeah,
no? No, no.
Oh, and Arthur.
Arthur is right.
When you get lost in New York City, yeah. When you get caught in the moon in New York City, you're at the Golden Globes.
That's good enough. Yeah. That's good enough. I think that's the title. I don't know. It says Arthur's theme, but I think that was the actual title. So give that point to Joe. Boy, I'm having too much fun. I don't want to wrap it up.
All right. Well, we have to. Oh,
I know.
And it's Friday. Fun.
All right.
Friday.
Here's one more.
One more. Okay.
One more.
Okay.
See if you know who this one is and what the movie is.
Oh, that's Cher.
Cher is right.
Oh, yes. You're not gonna stop me. You don't love me. You're not gonna stop me.
This is from 2010, and no, it's not. You're gonna no.
Oh, it's not Silkwood. Then it's too late.
Just say no, and then. Oh, is that with that boy? Was that Silkwood? No.
Oh, Mask.
No.
That's not Mask. 2010. Oh, and it's not the romantic, the moon one.
All right, who's the winner, Robin? We're close.
Oh, Jeff wins.
Jeff wins.
So come pick up your prize in the Civic Theater. We'll be calling.
Oh, sorry, Ann, I tried.
By the way, that's from a movie called Burlesque.
I was going to say that. Believe it or not, I won.
More conversation, less confrontation. The Mike Huckabee Show. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Governor Mike Huckabee.
And welcome to the Mike Huckabee Show. This is the Friday edition, and today I'm coming to you from New York City. That's right. Also, the first of the live shows I've been in this new calendar year. I've taken a few days off. I'll be talking about it later in the show as to where I've been, what I've done, but a little preview of it. I've been to some amazing historical places that have shaped our world, and I can tell you with certainty that it certainly has shaped my own worldview and life yet again to understand something about the price that many Americans have paid to give us our freedom. And I thought it was especially appropriate to be there at a time when back here in the United States, and specifically in Washington, our so-called leaders have essentially been skirting any real sense of responsibility and playing the most brazen political games with the future of young Americans yet to even be born. And we're going to talk about that a lot during this hour because I just think that, well, I hope people fully comprehend that what we have seen is gamesmanship, and we have seen political craftsmanship. What we have not seen is the kind of true statesmanship that is really the history and legacy of the United States of America. Meanwhile, President Obama back in Hawaii having a wonderful time. A large time, as they say. And in fact, he left in such a hurry, he didn't even have time to sign the magic fiscal cliff bill. He left it to aides to put it on the auto pen because he didn't want to be away from the sunny skies of Hawaii. Not that I blame him for wanting to go, but sometimes you wonder...